Hello everybody, this is Dimitrios and in this video I would like to do a kind of a review for the Line 6 Helix along with some thoughts of the other two competitors in the digital modeling scene, the AXEFX and the Kemper. Bear in mind that this is not going to be a traditional review in the sense of me showing you the capabilities and sounds of Helix rather than my own thoughts and the experience that I had using it the last year, and why did I purchase this instead of an AXEFX or a Kemper. The hot question out there is which one is better. I would like to address that, but also inform you what to expect from this technology in relevance to the analog pedals and tube amps. As a professional guitarist and tutor for over 20 years, I had the privilege to witness the birth of digital modeling, and through the years I used many products of this nature, along of course with traditional pedals and amps. I used to have the rack version of the Line 6 Pod XT, you know, the one after the bin, the red bin, and I must have played everything that Line 6 put out to the market, so I'm quite experienced in this company's products. Now, how about the other two? Well, the AXEFX is similar technology, but with the Helix, but way deeper and detailed in programmability and features, which for some it's gonna be a good thing or a bad thing depending on how much tweaking you like to do. The Kemper, on the other hand, is using a different technology by capturing a snapshot of your real amp. Many would say that you cannot compare the digital modeling with what Kemper does, but as far as I'm concerned, if I'm gonna buy any of those three products, I'm gonna plug my guitar in and expect a good sound on the other end. I mean, how they reach that goal, it doesn't really concern me. I'm a guitar player and not a tech guy, so I just want to hear a good sound out of this thing. So let's go back to the previous question, which one is better? Undoubtedly, the best sound comes from the AXEFX. The algorithm of that thing and the power under the hood is simply a class above the other two. But if you want ease of use, then this thing is quite complicated and it does have a steep learning curve. Also, the sound that you are getting is a little bit processed to look to sound polished. You know, if you know what I mean by that. So the Fractal is trying to sell you their idea of how good an amps and pedals sound through a good microphone, and yes, they are definitely achieving that at least 90% of the time. Second in line is the Kemper, which is your amp. If you actually buy the proper profiles, which means extra money to throw on third-party providers, and you are a quite proficient sound engineer, because you really need to know how to place that thing in a mix. Also, with Kemper, is what you hear is what you get situation. The tweaking is minimal, and when you are starting to mess with a profile, things are going south really fast. There are center profiles that are the most accurate representation of an amp and cab that I ever heard from a digital emulator, but in general, with Kemper is a hit or miss situation. Finally, we have the Helix, which has the worst sound of all three. So why did I purchase this one instead of the other two? Firstly, yes, indeed the other two have a better sound than the Helix, but really not so much better that I would justify the price difference. Secondly, the Helix is simply the most user-friendly from the bunch. You can learn how to operate this thing in half an hour and without a manual. Very easy to navigate, and when things go south in a gig, this is simply invaluable. Thirdly, since I have so much experience with the company, I can iron out the quirks really fast. The basic problems with the sound in Helix is in the opposite bands of equalization. Basically, the basses are flabby and the highs are harsh, but thankfully in Helix you can address this issue in contrary with previous products of Line 6. And yeah, before it was simply impossible to fix those issues, especially the basses. Lastly, the build quality is impeccable. This thing is a tank. One more thing on the positives is that the Helix sits quite well in a mix comparing with its predecessors. I mean, it was really fast to put it on a mix with minimal tweaking. On the negative side, I would not suggest this unit to heavy metal players unless you have some experience on how to manipulate Line 6 products. Basically, what to do with the equalization. Your best bet as a heavy metal player, I think it's the AxeFX. I think it has the best distortions, hands down. I would like to close this video discussing the main problem that all three units have, which is the feel. In order to make them sound as they're supposed to do when you're playing, you need to put excessive effort in your playing. And while the sound these days is quite good, the feel and the easiness of a good tube amp and pedal setup, simply it's not there. It's way, way easier to play on a tube amp and pedals than any of these units. I would describe this technology as a highly accurate picture of a painting. Yes, it looks exactly the same, but the experience is quite different. Not bad, but different. Just don't expect the same quality you would get with the real thing. That's all from me. I would love to read your thoughts in the comments and any experience that you might have with this equipment. I will put links down below if you want to check them out. They're not affiliate or anything, just so you can compare prices, etc. I want to thank you very much for watching. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. If you like to support me, please consider becoming a Patreon. And until next time, this is Dimitrios signing off. Peace.